So hello everyone, at this class I'm going to discuss about De Moivre's theorem. It is a part of a complex number, okay? So this De Moivre's theorem generally used in objective purpose, okay? So De Moivre's theorem kahan pe use hota hai? In case of polar form, jo polar form of a complex number hai wo polar form mein De Moivre's theorem use hota hai, or in Euler form, okay? So the main use of De Moivre's theorem is in polar form or in Euler form we can use. That is the shortcut method actually. This is the shortcut method. So look at the theorem. If n is an integer, then cos theta plus I sine theta whole thing to the power n. Cos theta plus I sine theta whole thing to the power n can be written as cos n theta plus I sine n theta. ये एक shortcut method है. अगर देखो power 100 है तो we cannot expand. If the power is 2 or if the power is 3, then we can expand easily. If the powers are more than 2, 3 or like 10, 11, 100, 200, then it will be difficult to expand. So in such case, we can use De Moivre's theorem. So basically, De Moivre's theorem can be used in polar form or Euler form. But if the power is more than 3, 4, 5, then generally we use this De Moivre's theorem. Alright. So cos theta plus I sine theta whole thing to the power n can be written as cos n theta plus I sine n theta. This is De Moivre's theorem. So similarly, cos theta plus I sin theta whole thing to the power minus n can be written as cos n theta minus I sin n theta. Since n is an integer, the power can be negative or positive also. So n ka value negative bhi ho sakta hai, positive bhi ho sakta hai. So if the power is negative, then it can be written as cos n theta plus I sin n theta minus I sin n theta. Why we need to give a plus sign before cos? Because we all know that cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. So that is why this minus will become plus here. Cos n theta minus I sine n theta. Here why we have to give minus sign? Because sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. Okay. Look at the next condition. Cos theta minus I sine theta whole thing to the power n. Cos theta minus I sin theta whole thing to the power n can be written as cos n theta minus I sin n theta. And the last case, cos theta minus I sin theta whole thing to the power minus n can be written as cos n theta minus minus, it will become plus. Why? Because sine of minus theta is minus sin theta. So that is why it will become plus. Plus I sin n theta. Okay, so these are the four possible results of De Moivre's theorem. And look, you can check the expression cos theta plus I sin theta. Generally, we can use in polar form, right? यहाँ पे r नहीं है. No doubt here r is not there, but the remaining part is belongs to polar form only. So basically, De Moivre's theorem can be used in polar form. That is the shortcut method to find the to evaluate the polar form. Alright. Okay. So apart from these four conditions, another two conditions I have written. You have to remember these conditions. Cis alpha. Now the question is, what is cis? C-I-S. Cis alpha into cis beta. This is equal to cis of alpha plus beta. Now what is cis? Look at here. Cos theta plus I sin theta, in short, can be written as cis. C for cos, I is the imaginary, S for sin. Okay, so cos theta plus I sin theta, in short, can be written as cis theta also. In short, can be written as cis theta also. So, chalo ek naya sa term mil gaya abhi. This is the new thing, right? So cos theta plus I sin theta sometimes can be written as cis theta, or generally ye sab objective questions mein hi zyada use hota hai. Cis theta, cis alpha, cis gamma. Okay. So cis alpha means cos alpha plus I sin alpha. into sis beta, that is cos beta plus I sin beta, can be written as sis of alpha plus beta, that is cos of alpha plus beta plus I sin of alpha plus beta. Look at the next condition, sis alpha by sis beta can be written as sis of alpha minus beta. Alright, few more cases are there, few more conditions are there, shortcut methods, all these things I will give in PDF. Alright, so just for timing, just you remember the theorem, de Moivre's theorem. Basically, it can be used in polar form or Euler form. Now I am going to discuss a few numericals related to this de Moivre's theorem. So, abhi thoda sa idea milega ke कहाँ पे पर्टिकुलर कौन सा टाइप का कैसा टाइप का क्वेश्चंस में डी मोइवर्स थ्योरम यूज किया जा सकता है. ऑलराइट, सो लेट अस डिस्कस अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन डी मोइवर्स थ्योरम. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इफ जेड इज इक्वल टू 7 minus i divided by 3 minus 4i. If z is equal to 7 minus i divided by 3 minus 4i, then find the value of z to the power 14. Here the options are given. First option is 2 power 7. Second option is I into 2 power 7. Third option, minus 2 power 7 into I. And the last option is none of this. So these four options are given. अभी देखो यहाँ पे de Moivre's theorem use करना है या नहीं है वो कैसे पता चलेगा? Because in the question it will not mention that whether we have to use de Moivre's theorem or any other theorem. So, क्वेश्चन को देख के पता लगाना पड़ेगा कि वेदर डी मोइवर्स थ्योरम इज एप्लीकेबल और सुइटेबल और नॉट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन. लुक एट द पावर, जेड इज गिवन, नो डाउट जेड इज गिवन 7 माइनस आई बाई 3 माइनस 4i, बट जिसका वैल्यू फाइंड आउट करना है उसका एक्सपोनेंट एक बार देखना है. पावर 14 है, सो पावर 14 है मतलब इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सपांड राइट टू द पावर 14. सो इन सच केसेस वी यूज डी मोइवर्स थ्योरम बिकॉज इट इज वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सपांड. अगर z स्क्वायर या फिर z क्यूब होता तो चलो ठीक है, किसी तरह एक्सपांड कर सकते हैं हम लोग z स्क्वायर और z क्यूब, बट इफ द पावर इज मोर देन 3-4 ना इट विल बी डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सपांड राइट. सो इन सच केसेस वी यूज डी मोइवर्स थ्योरम. तो चलो यहाँ पे z पावर 14 का वैल्यू फाइंड आउट करने के लिए डी मोइवर्स थ्योरम यूज करना है. बट बिफोर दैट लुक एट द गिवन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. This complex number is not in standard form because the standard form is x plus iy or a plus ib. Alright? So first of all, you have to express this complex number in the form of a plus ib. How can we express? By rationalization. So 3 plus 4i by 3 plus 4i. Always you have to rationalize by taking the conjugate of the denominator. Alright? Okay. So this is equal to, it will be then 21 plus 28i minus 3i, this will be minus 4i square, that is plus 4, divided by 9 plus 16. So 25 plus 25i divided by also 25. So it can be written as 1 plus i. So this is the value of z. Now we can say that this complex number is in standard form. It is in the form of a plus ib. Alright. Always you have to take care of the main expression. If the main expression is not in standard form, first of all, the first task is express in the standard form. And then you have to do the remaining work. Alright. Okay. So now we can say that it is in standard form. Now we have to find to the power 14. That is z to the power 14. So, since we have to use here de Moivre's theorem, ye to confirm ho gaya. So, de Moivre's theorem use karne ke liye, listen, de Moivre's theorem use karne ke liye, first of all, the given complex number you have to express in polar form. Yes or no? Because, jo de Moivre's theorem mein bataya tha, wo kya tha? If n is an integer, then cos theta plus I sine theta whole thing to the power n can be written as cos n theta plus I sine n theta. So cos theta plus I sine theta, from where we will get cos theta plus I sine theta? If you express the given complex number into polar form, then only we get cos theta plus I sine theta, yes or no, or sis theta, you can say. So first of all, you have to express or you have to convert the complex number into polar form. ओके okay, अभी पोलर फॉर्म में एक्सप्रेस करने के लिए वो लेंदी मेथड यूज करने का कोई फायदा नहीं है. और इफ यू वांट टू यूज यू कैन यूज बट इट विल टेक मोर टाइम. ओके सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू टू कन्वर्ट द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इनटू पोलर फॉर्म, वी हैव टू कंपेयर द गिवन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर विथ आर कॉस थीटा प्लस आई इंटू आर साइन थीटा. यस द वैल्यू ऑफ आर कॉस थीटा इज 1, इवन द वैल्यू ऑफ आर साइन थीटा इज ऑल्सो 1. Then what we have to do, squaring and adding. So r square equal to 2, which implies r is equal to root 2. Chalo, modulus ka value nikal gaya. Put the value of r in these two equations. Then cos theta is equal to, we will get 1 by root 2. Whereas sin theta is equal to, we will get same 1 by root 2 only. So the value of theta is pi by 4. Because we know the value of cos 45 degrees 1 by root 2. As well as sin 45 degrees 1 by root 2. Therefore, Z is equal to, write down the polar form now. What is the polar form? R into cos theta, that is cos pi by 4 plus I sine pi by 4. Alright? Always, yaad rakhna hai, De Moivre's theorem ka koi bhi task ho to, koi bhi sum ho to, first of all, you have to express the given complex number into standard form, then into polar form. So standard form mein express kiya, after that you have to convert it into polar form. So this is the polar form, alright? Okay, so this is the value of z. Therefore, z to the power 14 is equal to, root 2 is there, that means it will be then 2 to the power 7, cos 7 pi by 4 theta plus, this is theta only, okay? Cos 7 pi by 4 plus I sine 7 pi by 4. Okay, this is z to the power 14. But look at the options. Here the options are given 2 to the power 7, I into 2 to the power 7, minus 2 to the power 7 into I, and none of this. So now what we have to do? You know how to find the value of 7 pi by 4. So try to find the values of cos 7 pi by 4 and sin 7 pi by 4. So chalo ek ka value nikal ke dikhata hu. Cos 7 pi by 4. Already we have completed this part in trigonometry. So 7 pi by 4, first of all you convert it into degree measure. Pi can be replaced by 180, right? So this is equal to cos of, this is 180, 45, right? So 7 into 45. So cos 315. How to find the value of cos 315? 315 can be written as 360 minus 45. 360 minus 45. So 360 also can be written as 4 into 90 minus 45. So 360 minus theta lies in which quadrant? In third fourth quadrant. And in fourth quadrant, cos is always positive as per the ASTC rule. And moreover, here even multiple of 90 is there, so that there will be no change in the trigonometric function. So this is equal to cos 45, which is 1 by root 2. Alright? Okay, so the value of 7 pi by 4. The value of cos 7 pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. The value of cos 7 pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. Okay, so now try to find the value of sine 7 pi by 4 also. Try to find the value of sine 7 pi by 4. So the value of sine 315 degree, this is equal to sine, again 360 minus 45 lies in the fourth quadrant. So it will be minus sine theta, minus sine theta, that is minus 1 by root 2. Alright? Okay, so therefore, z to the power 14 is equal to, I want to substitute in this equation, z to the power 14 is equal to, then see what will happen, 2 to the power 7, the value of cos 7 pi by 4 is 1 by root 2, माइनस आई इन टू वन बाई रूट टू. यस, द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन सेवन पाई बाई फोर इज माइनस वन बाई रूट टू. चलो यहां से अगर मैं एलसीएम ले लूंगा तो फिर क्या रहेगा, टू टू दी पावर सेवन, टू टू दी पावर सेवन सो टू टू दी पावर सेवन एंड द डिनोमिनेटर विल बी रूट टू, वन माइनस वन माइनस आई, सो टू टू दी पावर सेवन बाई टू टू दी पावर हाफ बाई टू टू दी पावर हाफ वन माइनस आई. सो नाउ वट वी हैव टू डू, जस्ट वी नीड टू सिंप्लीफाई दिस पार्ट. ओके, टू टू दी पावर सेवन बाई टू टू दी पावर हाफ इंटू होल इंटू वन माइनस आई, होल इंटू वन माइनस आई. सो सेवन पाई बाई फोर दैट इज ट्वाइस पाई. Or else we can do one thing, there is another shortcut method, we can do one thing. Here z to the power 14 is there, so z to the power 14 means this will be 14 pi, sorry, this will be 14 pi by 4, this is also 14 pi by 4, 14 pi by 4, that is 7 pi by 2, 7 pi by 2, 2 to the power 7 into cos of 7 pi by 2 plus I sine of 7 pi by 2. So try to find out the value of cos 7 pi by 2. 7 pi by 2 can be written as cos of 7 into 180 by 2. That is 90 cos 630. Yes, the value of cos 630 now we have to find out. Cos of cos 630. There is a silly mistake. Actually, yahan pe 14 hona chahiye tha. Main 7 likha tha. So cos of 360 can be written as 360 can be written as that is a 600, or we can do one thing, 7 into 90 plus 0 also. Yes, 7 is odd number, so there will be change in the trigonometric function. This is equal to sine 0, the value of sine 0 is 0. Similarly, now try to find out the value of 7 pi by 2. 7 pi by 2 means sine of 630 degree. So sine 630 can be written as again same 7 into 90 plus 0. So it is cos 0. The value of cos 0 is 1. The value of cos 0 is 1. So 630. Now the question is, use the proper sign now. 630 degree lies in which quadrant? 630 degree lies in which quadrant? Look at here. If 360 degree lies in fourth quadrant, 360 plus 90, 450, 540. 630. 630 lies in the third quadrant. So as per the ASTC rule, in third quadrant, cos is always negative. So it will be 0 only, because 0 is a neutral value. Similarly, sine is also negative. So this is equal to minus 1. Alright? This is equal to minus 1. So therefore, z to the power 14 can be written as z to the power 14 can be written as 2 to the power 7, the value of cos 7 pi by 2 is 0, plus I into the value of 7, sin 7 pi by 2 is minus 1. Yes, so this is equal to minus I into 2 to the power 7. So third option is the correct answer. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा silly mistake हो गया था कि यहाँ पे z to the power 14 था, so I must write here 14. Instead of 14, I have written here 7. So that is why we are not getting the answer. Now it is correct only. Okay. So third option is the correct answer. So it is this type of questions. I will discuss some more questions. So in this type of questions only, we have to use de Moivre's theorem. Alright. So the next question I will discuss now. So take a look at the next question. This is important question. If root 3 plus I whole thing to the power 100. Look at here, the power. this power is 100, so it is difficult to expand. So that means here it is also confirmed that we have to use here de Moivre's theorem. Alright? Okay. So if root 3 plus I whole thing to the power 100 is equal to 2 to the power 99 whole into a plus ib, then find out the value of b. Find out the value of b. B is nothing but the imaginary part. Okay, so that means from both sides we have to equate the imaginary part. यहाँ पे real part का इतना कुछ functions नहीं है, फिर भी express तो करना पड़ेगा पहले polar form में. Yes, पहले first of all you have to express the left hand side part into polar form. Polar form is r cos theta plus I into r sin theta. Then only we can equate the imaginary and real part. Alright? Okay. So, first of all try to express the left hand side, that is root 3 plus I. Forget about the exponent now. Initially, exponent ke baare mein bhul jana hai, pehle isko polar form mein express karna hai. So, root 3 plus I ko polar form mein kaise express kiya ja sakta hai? So, if you compare this complex number with r cos theta plus I into r sin theta, then see what will happen. R cos theta is equal to root 3 and r sin theta is equal to 1. So therefore r square is equal to root 3 whole square plus 1, that is a 4. That is r is equal to 2, which is always greater than 0. Put the value of r in these two equations, then we will get cos theta is equal to root 3 by 2 and sin theta is equal to 1 by 2. Both are positive, lies in the first quadrant only. Okay, so therefore, theta, what will be the value of theta? Look at here, cos root 3 by 2, that means it is pi by 6. Pi by 6, right? So therefore, the polar form will be, the polar form of this complex number will be, the value of r is 2. So 2 whole into cos pi by 6 plus I into sin pi by 6. Alright? So this is z. Z means the left hand side part. So what now, look at the exponent. The exponent is given here 100. So therefore z to the power 100 is equal to 2 to the power 100 whole into cos of 100 pi by 6. 100 pi by 6 means 50 pi by 3 plus I sine of 50 pi by 3. Okay, so this is the value of the left hand side part. Now we can do one thing, we can equate the imaginary part, because you are asked to find out the value of b, and b is nothing but the imaginary part of the complex number. So here we can write it as 2 to the power 100 whole into cos of 50 pi by 3 plus I sine of 50 pi by 3. This is equal to 2 to the power 99 whole into a plus ib. So from here, if we cancel this 2, so sirf 2 bachega. Now if we equate the imaginary part, then see what will happen. B is equal to 2 into sine of 50 pi by 3. There is no function of the real part, so just we need to take out the imaginary part. Alright, so 2 into sine 50 pi by 3, sine of 50 into 180 by 3. So that means 2 into sine of 50 into 60, that is 3000. Yes, 50 into 60, that is 3000. So you have to find out the value of sine 3000 degrees. So sine 3000, it is difficult to find out the value, right? So 50 pi by 3 ko to fir hum log kya kar sakte, kaise break kar sakte, because it is difficult to find out the value of that is a 3000 degree na. So iska koi shortcut sochna padega, iska bhi koi shortcut sochna padega. Ye bhi trigonometric function mein hum log explain kiye the. So 2 sin of 50 pi by 3 ko, 50 pi by 3 ko main kya likh sakta hu, to fir can we write like this, that is 50 pi by 3, can we write like 16 pi plus 2 pi by 3, because 16 3 is a 48, 48 plus 2, that is 50 only. So 2 sine of, why I have written like this, because I just want to express this angle in the form of 90. So सो 16 इंटू पाई को मैं 32 इंटू पाई बाई 2 भी लिख सकता हूँ, प्लस 2 पाई बाई 3. नाउ 32 इंटू पाई बाई 2 लाइज इन विच क्वाड्रेंट? इफ 4 इंटू पाई बाई 2 लाइज इन द फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट, 4 इंटू पाई बाई 2 लाइज इन द फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट, 8 इंटू पाई बाई 2, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, and 32. So 32 into pi by 2 is also lies in the fourth quadrant, but plus theta is there, right? So plus theta means it will go to the next quadrant, that is after fourth quadrant. So fir se first quadrant aa jayega. Yes, so in first quadrant we all know that all trigonometric functions are positive, and moreover there will be no change in the trigonometric function. Why? Because 32 is an even number. So this is equal to 2 into sine of 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3 means 120 degree. The value of sine 120 degree is, what is the value of sine 60 degree? The value of sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2. So the value of sine 120 is also root 3 by 2. Because 120 degree lies in the second quadrant, and in second quadrant, as per the ASTC rule, sine function is always positive. So sine 2 pi by 3 is root 3 by 2. So 2 will be cancelled. Answer is root 3. This is important question. ठीक है, तो फिर हम लोगों को अभी कैसे पता चलेगा कि डी मोइबर्स थ्योरम कहाँ पे यूज करना है, जिसका एक्सपोनेंट मोर देन 3-4 होगा, तो जनरली इन सच केस वी हैव टू यूज डी मोइबर्स थ्योरम. यस, दिस इज एक्चुअली वन काइंड ऑफ शॉर्टकट मेथड. ऑलराइट, सो this is the next one. So I will discuss the next question now. So take a look at the next question. This is also important question. You are asked to find out the value of 4 plus 5 whole into minus half plus I root 3 by 2 whole thing to the power 3 4 plus 3 into minus half plus I root 3 by 2 whole thing to the power 365. So you are asked to find out the value of this complex number. So यहाँ पे क्या method use करना है, whether we have to use de Moivre's theorem or any other theorem. Look at the question, look at the solution. 4 plus 5 into, यहाँ पे जो value दिया गया है, that is minus 1 plus I root 3 by 2 whole thing to the power 3 4 plus 3 into, again minus 1 plus I root 3 by 2 whole thing to the power 365. So 4 plus 5 into, तो ये फॉर्मूला हम लोगों को पहले ही मिल चुका है, दैट इज कॉल्ड क्यूब रूट्स ऑफ यूनिटी. ओके, क्यूब रूट्स ऑफ यूनिटी, इफ यू सॉल्व एनी क्यूब रूट ऑफ यूनिटी रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन वी विल ऑलवेज गेट 3 रूट्स. वन मस्ट बी रियल एंड द अदर 2 रूट्स आर ऑलवेज इमेजिनरी, एंड दोज 2 इमेजिनरी रूट्स आर डिनोटेड बाई ओमेगा एंड ओमेगा स्क्वायर. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू रिमेंबर अबाउट ओमेगा एंड ओमेगा स्क्वायर. Minus 1 plus I root 3 by 2, it is the value of omega. Already we have discussed, so direct we can put here omega. So omega to the power 3 4 plus 3 into omega to the power 3 6 5. Yes, so 4 plus 5 into, what will be the value of omega to the power 3 3 4? 3 3 4 can be written as 3 3 3 into omega also, plus 3 into 365. Omega to the power 365 can be written as omega to the power, if you divide this one, it is not divisible by 3, right? Since it is not divisible by 3, let me check what will be the remainder then if you divide this exponent by 3, that is 12, 36, 5. There is omega square. Omega square. So you know the technique how to find out the value. So 4 plus 5 into, the value of omega to the power 3 3 3 is 1 only. So 5 omega plus 3 omega square. Alright, but look at the options. The options are given like this. So that means we have to use the conditions of omega. We know 1 plus omega square is equal to 0. Alright. So just try to arrange, if possible, try to arrange this complex number in the form of 1 plus omega square. from 4, if we take out 1 and then 5 omega, or else we can do one thing, from 4 you can write here 3, 5 omega say hum log 3 omega le liya, 3 omega square plus 4 say 3 le liya to fir 1 rahega, 5 omega say 3 omega le liya matlab 2 omega rahega. The value of, if you take here 3 common, it will be 1 plus omega square plus 1 plus 2 into, the value of omega is minus 1 plus I root 3 by 2, yes. So this value is 0, so 3 into 0 plus 1 plus, yaha se 2 cancel ho jayega, so it can be written as then minus 1 plus I root 3, so plus 1 minus 1 will be cancelled, so the answer is I root 3, third option is the correct answer. This type of questions are important. देखो, De Moivre's theorem में कभी कभी ऐसा omega cube root of unity related questions भी आ जाता है, ठीक है? So De Moivre's theorem, cube roots of unity, Euler form, polar form, these are required, these are important for objective, complex number objective questions, okay? So Euler form I have discussed, polar form also, even I have discussed today De Moivre's theorem, and before that I have discussed cube roots of unity also. I will continue the objective part of complex number in the next class also. So thank you for today.